Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see how to implement atoi function. Without wasting any time, let us look at the problem statement. Let us say you have been given a string which is containing integers. Now you want to convert this string into the integer format, and if it's possible then only you will convert, otherwise you will not. This function is known as the atoi function, where you are converting a string to its integral representation. Okay. So I would highly suggest you to try this code by yourself. I will just give you the idea behind solving this question, and I will also provide the code in the description section below, so you can just check it out if you face any problem. So let us look at the idea. By the way, you already know that if a string is given, then the last character is null by default. Okay, this is just a reminder. Now, if you have been given a string, let's say 3 to 4, now how will you convert it to an integer format? What you will do is you will iterate character by character. Okay. Even if you don't remember the ASCII code, then you can convert it into the integral format by just subtracting it with 0 character. Suppose if you have this first character as 3, okay, and I don't know what is the ASCII value of this 3. Now, you will just subtract the ASCII of 0 from this character 3, and you will get the result as the difference between their ASCII values, which will be 3. Okay, so in this way, even if you don't remember the ASCII value, you just subtract a given number with the base number, that is the lowest number possible, which is 0 I am assuming here, then you will get the value as 3. Okay, so this is the concept we will be applying. We will check each character. If it falls in the range, if by subtracting by 0 character, that means the current character, let's say character is C, and by subtracting it with 0, it should fall in the range from 0 to 9. Okay. So if it falls in the range between 0 to 9, then only it is an integral character, and then only we will convert it. So this 3 will be 3 minus 0, it will be 3. Okay. So this falls in the range from 0 to 9, therefore this is an integral character and we will save it in our result. So let us take a result variable which will be assigned to 0 initially. Now we will store it in result. Okay, so result will become 3, and now we will iterate to the next element, which is 2. Now what will be the value of this 2? 2 will be 2 minus character 0, which will be equals to 2. Now this 2 falls in the range between 0 to 9, therefore this is a valid integer. Now what you will do is, you will just multiply this result with 10 and then you will add 2 to it. What will be the result? It will be 32. Okay. Now you will move on to the next character, which is 4. Similarly, you will do character 4 minus 0 equals to 4, which falls in the range between 0 to 9. Therefore, you will just do result into 10 plus the value 4, which will be equals to 3 to 4. Okay, and now you will just reach the end of this string, and so your while loop will end, or your for loop will end. Okay, and then the number you got is 324. This is your integral representation. So this is how you implement atoi. Let us look at an invalid integral number and let's see how to convert it into integer. Let's say the number is 32a and null is at the end. Now you are starting from 3. Similarly, you will check 3 minus 0, which will be 3, and this falls in the range between 0 to 9, so it's valid. So what will be the value of result? Result was initially 0. 0 into 10 plus 3, which will be equals to 3. Now you will move on to the next character, 2. Now this 2 falls in the range between 0 to 9, so this is also a valid integer. Therefore, you will do result into 10 plus 2, which will be 32. Now you will move on to the next character, A. Now, ASCII value of A, you know that it's 97. You don't have to remember it actually. And then you will just subtract it by 0. And this will not fall in the range between 0 to 9. Because only the integral values will fall between the range of 0 to 9. So, as soon as this A minus 0 exceeds, or it's out of bounds from this range, you will quickly notice that it is not an integer. Therefore, what you will do is you will just return minus 1, saying that this cannot be converted to integer format. Okay, I think by now you must have understood the idea behind atoi implementation. So you must implement it by yourself. But if you find any problem, then do look at the code which is given in the description section below. Now, what is the time complexity and the space complexity? Since we are just traversing the given string only once, therefore the time complexity will be order of string length. And let's say string length is n, then it will be order of n. And what will be the space complexity? We are just taking a single extra variable, so it can be considered to be order of 1. So this is the time and space complexity for implementing atoi. So please implement it, and if you find any problem, then do comment below and I'll help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you on our next video. Thank you.